चैप्टर 12 भक्ति योग द योग ऑफ डिवोशन शोइंग द कॉस्मिक फॉर्म लॉर्ड केम टू नेचुरल कॉन्टिनेंस इन द माइंड ऑफ अर्जुन इट एनहेंस्ड फेथ एंड रेवरेंस अर्जुन सेड ओ गॉड यू हैव टू फॉर्म्स फिजिकल एंड कॉस्मिक स्टेट टू यूनाइट विद दी Which one must I meditate? Lord smiled at the curiosity, revealed the real wisdom. You saw the cosmic form of the absolute, the formless Brahma. Those meditating God always worship faithfully and stay firm. God they see everywhere. Finally they merge in Him. For benefit of all beings they work, senses they restrain, keeping the mind fixed always. God such devotees attain. This meditation of unmanifested, unnamed and the highest. He who achieves it, certainly he becomes Brahma himself. But those meditating on the unmanifested, obstacle they find, quite hard to attain the aim, for extremely fickle is mind. In fact, it is not possible for all embodied beings. Listen to an easier way for all those living in families. Meditating on the physical form, to me who turns, and worships with utmost devotion, to me he comes. Merging mind in me ever remains in the state of yoga. With utmost faith in mind, know him the yoga yukta. Firmly who follows my word, performs all actions, dedicating all works to me, the religion thus he reckons. Stays firm on a single aim, with mind undeviating. Such steadfast devotees certainly attain my blessing. Those who muse in me, by mind and consciousness, I certainly salvage them from the worldly ocean and bless. Pandit said, O Lord, in this form, Yogeshwar Krishna, you are, imparted me the real wisdom which I was searching for. Curious I am to know, please make the concept clear. One who turns to devotion, to what rules one must adhere? Shri Prabhuji said, certain rules devotee follows, it is most important. Great qualities he inculcates himself. Listen with intent. Lord himself declared the qualities in a devotee we find. 35 are these. One must always bear in mind. First quality, worships God with love and reverence. Dedicates everything to God with mind and intelligence. Those who remain yukta ever, with unperturbed mind, having the second quality, the grace of God they find. With utmost faith in mind, worship of God who loves. With the third quality, yoga yukta one becomes. Controls all the senses, to strict discipline he adheres. The fourth quality in mind, the devotee always bears. Remains with intelligence equitable to all everywhere. The fifth quality of those who worship God and revere. Benevolence to all beings without any partiality. This is the sixth quality, the devotee's speciality. Dedicates all works to God. On God alone he depends. With the seventh quality, the best devotee one becomes, clings to one form of God, with firm mind he meditates. He beholds God indeed, the eighth quality who inculcates. Ninth quality, you know, he surrenders his soul, with devotion to lotus feet of Lord, finds the supreme soul. Unbiased to all beings, without any trace of hate, dear to the world he becomes, tenth quality is great. Egoless one becomes, free of pride devotee remains. Know it, 11th quality, Lord Krishna thus explains. With mind merciful always, know him the best devotee. Such is 12th quality, the devotee's true identity. Devotee dwells indifferent, free of attachment and ignorance. 13th quality is thus indeed of great importance. Devotee of God is friendly to all, with enmity to none. With the 14th quality, one becomes dear to everyone. Equable in pleasure and pain, thus dwells a devotee. Incomparable he stands, who attains the 15th quality. Contented person is always happy, the eternal principle. With the 16th quality, his mind remains peaceful. Devotee is self-governed, disciplined life he leads. Adheres to the 17th rule, to salvation he proceeds. Determined to devotion, never resorts to carelessness. By the 18th quality, never one finds any distress. Yogi or devotee never offends, nor agitates anyone. The 19th quality is great, it comforts everyone. Yogi never gets agitated on seeing others' flaws. Free of flaws he lives, 20th quality he draws. Devotee stays untouched by joy, grief, fear and jealousy. Tranquil life yogi lives, the 21st quality. Lives free of desires, marked as 22nd quality, called anapeksha, thus dwells a disciplined yogi. Pure from body and mind, thus a devotee dwells. 23rd quality of the yogi, the Gita here tells. Professionalism in life, dexterity in own work he obtains. Devotee must ensure the 24th quality he attains. Indifferent to loss and profit, thus a yogi stays. The 25th quality, yogi within inculcates. All grieve in sorrow, but yogi never grieves. Gat Vyatha, the 26th quality he achieves. All initiate works according to their own ambitions. By all means, yogi renounces all initiations. It is renunciation of sense of doership, the Gita thus explains. With the 27th virtue, salvation one attains. Yogi always remains free, away from ecstasy and envy. Lives a trouble-free life with the 28th quality. Yogi renounces all, the auspicious as well as ominous. The 29th quality makes the yogi famous. Devotee behaves equally with foe and friends. Unbiased yogi ever stays. Lord of the world he becomes. greatly beneficial indeed, this virtue of equality. Dear to all he becomes due to the 30th quality. In honor and insult, equable yogi stays ever. Neither disturbed in insult, nor he expects any honor. 31st quality thus we find in the yogi who becomes all crave for honor. To no temptation yogi succumbs. Consistent in hot and cold, such is yogi's nature. Favorable and adverse, he treats with pleasure. In a rare person we find this 32nd quality. Devotee never deviates, leads a life of austerity. Let all know 33rd quality. Lord in the Gita says, yogi avoids company of various cults, never he strays. Silence is the great virtue, yogi keeps mum. Serene is the silent contemplation, the mother of wisdom. Know it 34th quality, samadhi's very essence. One crosses the worldly ocean, who practices with patience. Great is the 35th quality, the stability of intelligence. On the path of yoga, it attains utmost importance. The essence of religion these qualities consist, by this who abides, for the divine sight of God certainly one qualifies. Those who drink this nectar of dharma and commit to me, reckon me as their supreme goal, they are dear to me. Pandit said, my lord, I am astonished. Please tell me, I pray. Ideal is the way of dharma. Is it possible to practice today? Shri Prabhuji said, by fervid faith and constant practice, it is possible. But along with these qualities, one needs wisdom as well. Be certain, dear, without wisdom, nothing one attains. The wisdom yogi acquires, the Gita next explains. Note, 35 qualities of a devotee are 1. Submits mind and body to God. 2. Constantly contemplative. 3. Has absolute faith and reverence. 4. Control over the senses. 5. Equitable intelligence. 6. Loves all living beings. 7. Dedicates all deeds to God. 8. Devoted to one alone. 9. Surrenders self to God. 10. Unenvious to all beings. 11. Egoless. 12. Merciful. 13. Detached or away from attachment and passions. 14th, friendly to all everywhere. 15th, equitable in comforts and troubles. 16th, satisfied. 17th, self-restrained. 18th, firm determination. 19th, free from anger. 20th, remains undisturbed. 21. Equipoised in joy and sorrow. 22. Has no expectations. 23. Purity of mind and body. 24. Expertise in actions. 25. Indifferent to loss and gain. 26. Free from all troubles. 27. Gives up all initiatives. Works without expectation. 28. Free from envious feelings. 29. Free from auspicious and ominous. 30. Even-minded to friend and foe. 31. Unperturbed in honor and insult. 32. Equipoised in hot and cold weather. 33. Avoids company of worldly people. 34. Keeps silence. 35. Has firm intelligence, that's higher or intuitive intelligence. Thus ends the Upanishad of the celestial song, the knowledge of God realization, the scripture of yoga, the dialogue between Lord Krishna and Arjuna named Bhakti Yoga, the yoga of devotion. Om.